Namaste. In this video, I'm going to talk to you about moon. I'm also going to talk to you about one temple in along the banks of river Kaveri, which is a great remedial measure for moon. So let's begin. Moon, when we say moon is known as Manahkaraka. Manah, people call it wrongly as mind, but there is more to it. But moon represents multiple things. Moon represents mother, moon represents milk, moon represents feminine energy, moon represents vegetation. There are many things that moon represents. One of the important things that moon represents is manas. Now manas, what is manas? Manas can be understood as memory. Whenever there is any disturbance of moon, or whenever the energies of the moon are not being received in the right manner, then what happens is your mental ability gets disturbed a lot. It could be in the form of a negative feeling, it could be in the form of suicidal tendencies, it could be depression, it could be a situation where there is extreme amount of anxiety and you really do not know what to do. And all these are related to moon. Whenever moon energies are low, the things that I told you with regard to mind manifests. And they manifest in a very negative manner. In fact, at an extreme level, it also gives a lot of suicidal tendencies. So if at any point of time, there's a level of frustration that kicks in, there is that cluelessness that you come up with. You do not know exactly what to do, and you'll be thinking, why is this happening? What should I do next? What is my next action that settles things down? Why is that I don't have a fixation on a particular topic? Why is that my mind continuously oscillates over a period of time? All these things are primarily because either in the transit or in the horoscope or in the Dasha Bhukti, moon's influence is negative for you as an individual. So if you have this type of problem, if you are feeling a little helplessness and you're not able to make the right decisions, or you're not able to really understand what to do next, or if you're feeling very insecure, if you want your mind to start stabilizing, if you want your mind to start calming, if you want to bring that mind from a monkey's mind to a monk's mind, then resorting to remedial measures with respect to moon will be working wonders for you. Now, how do you do that? There are two things that I'm going to suggest for you. First and foremost, if you are in Karnataka, now along the banks of Kaveri, somewhere around the Mandya area, there is a temple, a very small temple, that's called the Someshwara Temple. I had the privilege of visiting the Someshwara Temple yesterday. Someshwara, the word Someshwara has two words, Soma and Ishwara. Soma means moon, and Ishwara naturally is Lord Shiva. Someshwara is in the form of a linga. For those people who have regularly consulted me, you would have heard me saying that Shiva has to be worshipped in four different formats, depending on how the placement of certain planets are there in your horoscope. Now, one such format is the linga swarupa. So, coming to the Someshwara temple, visiting this temple, and doing an archana in your name will be a very good remedy if you have moon-related problems. Now, for those people who are not nearby, and if it is very difficult for you to come to this temple, there's another very equally powerful remedy that I would recommend. This remedy is based on the Mantra Shastra, and in Mantra Shastra there are different types of mantras. What I am giving you is the Sattvic type of mantra. So when I say Sattvic mantra, it essentially means you don't need to have any Diksha. Somebody doesn't need to come and give you an initiation into this mantra. You can just hear this, whatever I am saying, and go ahead and start repeating it. The mantra is Om Shan Somaya Nama. Now, for those people who are students of astrology, you would have suddenly realized that I've used the word Shan. Shan actually is for Saturn. But this mantra, Om Shan Somaya Namaha, is a combination of Saturn and Moon. And this combination actually gravitates the mind into one central position. So this will help you transition from being a monkey's mind to a monk's mind. You need to repeat this mantra 108 times at the minimum. That means one mala. If you are having a Rudraksha mala, use the Rudraksha mala. It can be a very simple Panchamukhi Rudraksha mala. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have any specific questions, feel free to leave your comments below. Don't forget to like this or dislike this if you didn't like it. And don't forget to share it with your friends. Till next time, Namaste.